5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
A questo punto, che consiglio abbiamo un intervento e a cui personalmente tengo molto, perché è un intervento di una persona che viene da Ghana, è una donna, è stata definita una delle 25 maggiori esperte al mondo di robotica e lavora in Ghana. Si occupa molto di education e ci tiene molto. Brenda, Mboya!
If you have to focus on the fourth industry. robot team navigate simple projects, use sensors, cameras, just to get them curious and interested in STEM and robotics. Just a little statistics about this year's artistic innovation experience. 51% of the participants this year were female, which is very impressive because for a long time we've seen a trend of not many women being involved in the science education, but now we're seeing 51% of them being involved in robotics, being involved in design and engineering. Only 49% were men, which is still a good number. And I mean, the best would be to have 50-50, but according to this year's statistics, it was 51% female, 49% male. And we had 14 countries represented, from Ghana, from Africa, and outside the world. So because of my interest in robotics education, I was invited by the Norman Foster Foundation in 2018 to explore with other roboticists how robotics is affecting architecture. And together with 10 other students from different parts of the world, we engaged in designing models using industrial robots and trying to predict how robots are going to, you know, change architecture. And inspired by this experience, I decided to research on who else is interested in robotics like I am, who else can I collaborate with in Africa, so that we inspire more young people to collaborate or to work on robotics. My key findings, as I'm almost concluding, which I like to describe as the roboscape. The roboscape in Africa is how robotics looks like in Africa. And I have to talk about only three organizations which I think are doing amazing work in Africa. One is the first one I mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, which is the IQ Lab, based in Ethiopia, just on top of Kenya. Kenya is the green one, Ethiopia is just at the top. And the IQ Lab team organizes conferences and, you know, projects where they encourage students to work on robotics. Another important organization is the Robotics Foundation in Accra. And I was excited to find out that in this year's RoboFest, students from the foundation were the first. In conclusion, because I've run out of time, I think that way back in 2000s, when I was thinking about robotics as a form of entertainment, in 2019, students or young Africans are seeing robotics as an opportunity for innovation, as an opportunity for, you know, building new models and, you know, creating change. And I believe that Africa is really, really, really going to move forward in the fourth industrial revolution.